Following the Ministry of Education's pronouncement to enhance production unit in schools, Chelenge Secondary has not been left out. In the school, children are taught different vocational and entrepreneurial skills. Meet Hantumba Blessing, a grade 11 pupil, as he explains the production of mushroom.
My name is Blessed Hantumba here at Chelenge Secondary School, and here I'll be showing you how to grow mushrooms. In order to grow mushrooms, the first thing you need to have two rooms. You need to have the dark room, which is also referred to as the incubating room. Then you also need the fruiting room. The fruiting room, there's need for light, because for mushrooms to grow, they'll be needing light. In the dark room, in order for the mushrooms to colonize, they don't need light. Then the other thing you will need is you will need a substrate. A substrate is any medium which you can use, which you can plant in, spawn. Then a substrate can be any carbon source material. So here you can use any carbon source material, which can be dry grass, dry leaves, or it can be dry groundnut stalks. Now here we have dry bean stalks. So here I'll demonstrate how to the first part of preparing the substrate, which is the chopping stage. When chopping the substrate, the substrate should be chopped to a length of 2 to 6 centimeters. If you can ask why we're chopping it to 2 to 6 centimeters, it's to allow easy colonization. After this stage, we move on to the next stage, which is the washing stage, where we'll be washing this cut substrate. Now, before we go to the washing stage, we need to get some water. Then we put the water in this pot, like I have demonstrated here. There's water in the pot. Then this pot, as you can see, the water, there's a source of heat which is heating the pot. And we need to preheat the water before we go on to the next stage. So here, I'll need to add gypsum, which I'll need to add to the water. And this should be equivalent to 2 teaspoons. Now we have added this. Hydrated lime. The reason why we added this hydrated lime is to add the right pH value to the substrate in which we'll be planting the sperm. After this, we go on to the next part, which is the washing stage. Okay, now we'll move on to the washing stage. Before we start washing the chopped substrate, we have to add to the water. We need to add the dishwasher, like boom. The reason why we are adding that is because when we'll be washing the substrate, we want all the dirt that's with the substrate to be removed. And we'll be also adding jik, which is two to three drops of jik. Then the reason why we are adding this to this is to kill some bacteria from the substrate, at their end. So here we'll be washing the substrate. Now, after we've washed the substrate, you need to make sure that the substrate has been thoroughly washed. The next part will be packing of the substrate. So you need to get a sack. As you can see, this sack is wet, and this sack has been disinfected. The reason why it has been disinfected is because in the atmosphere, there are a lot of molds. I mean, there are a lot of fungi. And if these fungi get to on the sack, they might colonize the substrate, thereby creating some things which look like mushrooms, but they are very poisonous. So right now we will be packing this up. The next part will be the stage of pasteurization or the heating stage. So what I'll need to do before putting the sack into the preheated water, I need to make sure that the temperature of the water is 75 to 85 degrees. So I'll now measure the temperature of the water. After you've measured the temperature of the water, and make sure that the temperature is between 75 to 85 degrees Celsius. The reason why you should not allow the temperature to get below 75 or above 85 degrees Celsius is because if it goes above, it might kill the important bacteria which will be required during mushroom production. And between 0 degrees to 85 degrees, all the harmful bacteria should be destroyed. But now you have to get the sack containing the washed substrate. After getting the sack, remember we've already added the hydrated lime to the water to provide the right pH. Here you have to dip the sack into the water. After you've placed the sack into the preheated water, you need to keep a close watch on the pot and the water to make sure that the temperature ranges between 75 and 85 degrees Celsius for the reasons that I've already provided. Now, in this, the sack will stay in the pot for 40 minutes. This is the draining bay or the cooling bay. You can call it like that. You need to make sure that this room is well disinfected. Before getting the bag, you have to disinfect your hands and also your feet. You remove the substrate from the sack. After removing the substrate from the sack, you spread it around to get rid of the water and also as a way of cooling it down. After a while, after the substrate has been fully cooled, the next part will be the part where we'll be planting the spawn. The bag should be well disinfected. After getting the bag, which is disinfected, even if it's new, the next part is the part where you plant the spawn. This is the spawn, which is the mushroom seeds. After this, you get to place it here on the middle. After placing it on the middle, you cover it with the substrate. After covering it with the substrate, you get to get it. Then you place it in the bag. After you've planted the spawn in this plastic bag, the next part you have to bring it here. As you can see, this place is dark. It's called the incubator or the dark room. You get to place the planted bag into the shelf. When you place it into this shelf, you have to make sure that it stays in this dark room for about 10 to 15 days until you wait until it's fully colonized. This is called the dark room. The dark room has several features, as you can see. When you look at the dark room, it looks very dark. And the reason why it should be dark is to allow colonization to take place. During colonization, there's no need for light. Then when you look at the ground, there's some sand and there's some charcoal. The reason why we're putting charcoal is because charcoal can hold water for rather a longer period of time than sand. As we know that sand has good drainage, but it has poor capillarity. When you look over there, when you look at the there's a plastic under the sand to prevent the water from going too deep underground. Now, in this dark room, you need to close the shelf to make sure that the room is completely dark. After getting the planted bug from the dark room, after it has stayed in there for about 10 to 15 days, you will discover that the bug has been fully colonized. As you can see, the bug is looking very whitish, like this. In the fruiting room, there's need for light and proper air circulation for mushrooms to grow. You get to tie them. You can put them in a bag or in a bucket. Then you tie them to the rails. You tie them to the rails like this. After tying them, you need to cut some holes. You need to cut some holes on the bag in which you planted the spawn. The reason why we are cutting the holes in the bag which you planted the spawn, the holes which you cut on the plastic, those holes, that's where the mushrooms will be coming out. Now, after 2 to 3 days, you discover that the mushrooms will start coming out. As you can see, the mushrooms are coming out from the holes which have been cut on the plastic. Then after every week, you'll be harvesting about one time every week for 6 months. One time every week for 6 months. How to maintain the fruiting room? The fruiting room, you must make sure that there's proper circulation of air, as I've stated, and you need to make sure that there's light in the room for mushrooms to grow up. The other thing is that you need to make sure that the humidity of you need to constantly check the humidity of the room, because mushrooms don't need water, but mushrooms need water vapor, which is humidity. And you have to make sure that the humidity ranges from about 80 to 100. And also make sure that the temperature ranges to about 19 to 25 degrees Celsius. If the temperature goes down, or if the humidity goes down, you need to spray some water. I mean, you can get a sprayer to mist the bags, or if the temperature has gone very low, you can even spray some splash some water to the walls, and also you need to put some water on the sand below so that the humidity can go back to its original the required humidity for mushrooms to grow. For every harvest, you might be making about 2,000 every harvest, which means 2,000 every week. In this sack, each pack we sell it at 20 kwacha each. So this is 20, and this is also 20 kwacha. So come and buy mushrooms and Chelenge Secondary School.
Thanks.
At the end, the activity makes everyone happy. Teachers and the local community enjoy this mushroom all year round. For orders or any other information, the number to call is 0964-112184. This has been Ryan Mtanti reporting for Sound Pro Media House, Nchelenge.